BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
Suited to the upright. Yeah. Give thanks to Jehovah with the lyre. Sing praises to him with the 10-string harp. Sing to him a new song. Make music at your best among shouts of joy. Who wants to shout the joy to the Lord today? Who wants to shout to the Lord today? Come on! Shalom.
Let's fade I am in your What is it all about in the people of God? You know, we offend him, we walk away, we forget about him, we get too busy, we get confused, we listen to wrong messages, and then he forgives. And in the meantime, we get ourselves in trouble, and then we have to rely on hope. He's faithful, we're not. Let's remember that. That's why we can have hope, because he's faithful. And he is able. We get ourselves into the worst messes, but he is able, no matter how much damage we do, no matter how many times we fail.
Amen.
He's the only one who can get you out of it.
Amen.
Yes.
So right now, the land of Israel is in a lot of trouble because they've been unfaithful again, as we all are. And their hearts are feeling the pain now. But God said that pain he uses for his good. Because when we're not in pain, we ignore him. Don't we? Right? Aren't you on your face talking to him every time you lose your job, you get sick, you're in trouble? But do you talk to him like that the other times? Do you? I don't think so. I think when you're on your face, that's when you're talking to him. When he's standing on your back, that's when you're communicating with him. So next time he's got you in pain, why don't you say, thanks, Lord? But right now, let's intercede for the world, but mostly for Israel, and ask him for that mercy that we need to hope in.
Aleluya, gloria a tu nombre, Señor.
Precioso
es el gozo. Aleluya.
Let's do our Shema.
Shema Israel.
In this time of the Feast of Dedication, may they realize their mistakes that is causing all the violence in the land, that you're raising up an enemy surrounding them, as you did with Antiochus Epiphanes. Let us understand our mistakes before it's too late. Open up their hearts, Lord, for only you are able. In your name, Yeshua. Amen.
In this season of the Feast of Dedication, there's a traditional song that has been sung for generations. I'm going to read it to you. It's Ma'ot Sur Yeshuati, Lekha Na'eh L'Shabeach, Tikun Beit Tefilati, B'Sham Toda Nezabeach, Leit Tachin Madbeach, Mitzar Ham Nabeach. Az Egmor Bashir Mizmor Chanukat Hamizbeach. Rock of Ages, let our song praise your saving power. Thou amidst the raging foes was our sheltering tower. Furious they assailed us, but thine arm availed us, and thy word broke their sword when our own strength failed us. In this season of brokenness, people all over the world, and in the United States, amazingly, have broken their relationship with the one true God. And Yeshua is the only way. He's our rock. So I'd like to sing this song today with that hope in mind, that it looked like a feeble disaster. The temple was destroyed, God's people were scattered and killed, and they finally started praying. They knew they broke their word to God. But the priests, Mattathias the priest, what a great guy, and his sons, his family was united back the temple. So, what are we dedicated to? Let's declare our dedication and praise him in advance that he's going to make this all work out fine, and his people will be in the land, and he will reign gloriously.
Love, calm, 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 calm.
Face to face.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Now we're going to do a new song.
All right, our rock, our stronghold. He's on his way, you know, he's packing his bags, he's getting things ready. And we're just waiting for him to return. But unfortunately, there's a lot of people who aren't going to recognize him, and they're not ready. They have no idea what's going on. So the believers have a responsibility to hold strong, no matter how much the enemy pushes you back. You got to stand back up again. If he knocks you down, you've got to get back up. There is no room for failure here. We've got to stand up and walk. So we're asking the question, what will it be like that day when he arrives?
What will you do in the day of Messiah? What will you do in the day that he comes? Bye.
what the hope is all about, you know. It says be ready to explain the hope that you have so that when anybody asks why you have so much hope, you don't stand there blank staring at them, but you know. Before we get to that glorious ending, there's a lot more to the story.
Tristan, we need the phone.
And so, let's sing a song about the real hope, his unfailing love. The storms are coming, we know it. Yeshua said, don't be afraid, so I'm not. But that doesn't mean I can't cry out for help. So let's sing this beautiful prayer about the unfailing hope that we have in his unfailing love. Because that's what's going to get us through it. All of us together, that's what's going to get us through it.
Thank you.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into his eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of his kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with a reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.